Hi everyone, my name is Ray and I am the founder of Productive Co. In my quest to make things run more efficiently and effectively, I discovered Dubsado. It's my favorite CRM to use. I was not a natural learner of Dubsado, and if I can figure it out, I promise you can too. That's why I've created this series of videos in conjunction with a freebie called the Dubsado Blueprint to help you set up Dubsado with a plan of action. If you haven't downloaded the blueprint already, I'll link to it so that you can follow along with these videos. This is the first step in Dubsado, which is getting your land and surveying it. So in this video, we are going to take a tour of your portal after you sign up for Dubsado. When you log into Dubsado, you'll be taken to your dashboard. That's what you see here. This is the front page of your dashboard. You will be able to see a snapshot of your calendar for the upcoming week. You will also be able to see a list of to-dos if you have any. There will be a notice for unread alerts. You can see a quick glance of your financial overview, and you can add new jobs or leads right here from this front page. If you go up to where the area of your logo belongs in the upper right corner, you will be able to see notifications and your inbox. So if you want to take a look at your inbox, you would simply click on that. It says I have nothing in here. If you want to see unread notifications, you can just click this here and it will show you if you have any. If you go over to the left side, a pane will open up and you can see all the other tabs you can go to. You can go to leads. Leads are people who are not your clients yet. They're prospective clients. You can add them here and you can click on their name to be taken to a page that's only their information. You can also go to jobs. Jobs is for people who are your paying clients. You can convert leads into jobs and jobs back into leads if something doesn't work out. It looks kind of similar to the leads page, except it doesn't have funnel tabs at the moment. So funnel tabs, I'll take you back. You can create different statuses for your leads to see where they are in the pipeline. If you want to keep track of who needs a follow-up call, who needs a interview, you can create statuses just by clicking add and edit statuses. At the moment, you can't do that in jobs. It is something that's being doled out soon in Dubsado. And you can take a look at all past and overdue jobs as well. Then there's your bookkeeping tab. You have a few different options with your bookkeeping. You can look at your invoices, all of your transactions, your chart of accounts, and your reports. So I'll take you to the chart of accounts. Here you can see all of your income and all of your expenses. You can also export in your profit and loss for your bookkeeper or accountant. And then there's the calendar page. This is where you can hook up your calendar and you can see your calendar in a month, week, or day snapshot. Your form list, I'll explain in a moment. You can create task boards if you have items that you want to mark as to-dos. Your address book will house all of your client contact information for every job or lead that you add. You can then track your time in the time tracker. You can see what you've invoiced and what you haven't. And then there's the template section. You can click forms. This is where you create your contracts, your questionnaires, your welcome kits. And whenever you create those and send them to somebody, they'll show up in the form list here. So I'll just click on this really quickly and you can see all the forms that I've sent out already. I'll take you back into templates and then you can create canned emails. So if you have emails that you regularly send clients, you can create a template in the canned email section, and you can customize as needed. Then there's packages. If you offer your services for the same price every single time, you can create a package here. So you can create a package for logo design, you can create a package for web design, you can create a package for logo and web design, and list the price there. Then there's invoices. So this is your invoice template. If you need to add sales tax or some other type of tax, you can add those items here. You can then include those tax items in your packages. And then you can create your workflow. You're going to create your entire client experience right here. So you will add different actions to prompt yourself what you need to do or to automate it right here. So if you need to send an email out and then book an interview and then send a thank you message, then send a proposal, you will list all those things here and link them up together. This is the area of Dubsado that's sort of the backbone of this program. You can connect all the different elements in your template section in here, and this is where automation happens. So if you're looking to have things done for you without you manually doing them, that's going to happen in this workflow section. Another tab is called payment schedules. So if you have a service, say for $1,000, but you don't need your client to pay the $1,000 all at once, you can break that up into smaller payments and due dates here. Then there's the custom mapped fields. If you ask a client a question, like what their address is, it will automatically take their address and put it in the address book. That's called a mapped field. This is an area where you can create custom fields. So you can tell Dubsado that maybe you want to collect their Instagram handle and save it somewhere. Maybe you want to find out their birthday or their login to a software. You can gather that information here and make sure that it inputs somewhere else. You can always ask them in a questionnaire and just keep it in that questionnaire, but if you want to have that information sent to another area, you would use custom mapped fields. And there you have it. You have just taken a tour through Dubsado. You know where everything lives now, and you're ready to start building out your software. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want more tips and tricks on how to use Dubsado. I'll see you in the next video.